The steadfast sun and I both grasp its fervent brilliance. In a land where water is locked up, in the very depth of desiccated rocks, the trees are ashamed of their frozen fruit. The harnessed archer is laid waste. Such a blooded carpet is sprayed before the future. Yesterday, leaning on my can, I returned from the tree's crimination. Today, I search the ashes for my last homeless phoenix. Perhaps it was you who shadowed me. Perhaps it was only my shadow. Even though the lucky man in my land lack star in the heaven, lack shadow on the earth, they welcome any star that grace their devastated sky. Oh, my friend, my only friend, turn your anguish into constellation. The second one is a beauty. I want to recite this poem for Mary Fisher. Because yesterday, when I listened to her, that she had her presentation, for beautiful presentation, for beautiful voice. Your voice is like a girl from the farthest grain village, whose tall and graceful frame is known to the pine trees on the mountains. Your voice is like a girl who at dusk will bet in the clear spring of heaven, beneath the parasol of the moon, who at dawn bears home a jar of pure light, who will drink sip by sip from the river of the soul. Your voice is like a girl from the farthest grain village, who wear an anklet forked from the song of a brook, who wears an earring spun from the whispering rain, who wears a necklace woven from the silk of waterfall, all of which grace the garden of the sun, with dear many colored blossom of love, and you are as beautiful as your body.